Hello everyone, and welcome back to our Character Creator series in Godot 4. In the previous part, we created the UI for our Character Creator screen, and we connected all of our signal functions to our scripts. In this part, we will finish off our Character Creator scene by adding functionality to our buttons and text boxes to update our player values in real time. So let's open up our project, and we will start by updating our body sprite collection and color. So open up your body script that is connected to your body node, and let's start with our onCollectionButtonPressSignal function. In this function, we will cycle through our body keys to the next body sprite when a button is pressed. We'll do so by updating our current body index value, and then updating our sprite to show the reflected changes. We can do the same for our color, but instead of cycling through our bodies, we will cycle through our skin tones. So each time we press the button, our index will increase by 1, so we're going forward in our array. So it will go on to the next color or the next preloaded sprite sheet to change our color or our body or our accessory, etc. With this in mind, you can also probably use this to add a button that can go backwards, and then instead of adding 1 to the current body index, you remove 1. So you say -1, and that will go back to the previously selected body or skin tone or outfit or accessory. Now if we run our scene, we should be able to change our skin tone. Remember, if we add more than 1 body, our body would also change if we press this button. Let's do the same for our remaining features. Now if we run our scene, we should be able to update our hair, outfit, and accessory, as well as their colors. The last thing that we need to do is to change our name and redirect our game to our main scene when the player presses the confirm button. we'll need to get a reference to our text edit node, and based on the value of the text that we are entering into it, we will set that value to be our player's name. Then when we press the confirm button, we will set this player name value to be equals to our global player name variable, and then we'll change our scene to our main scene. Now if you run your scene, you should be able to set your name and change your features. The only problem we have here is that we won't see the changes in our player scene yet, since we aren't porting the values over to our player skeleton. We'll do that in the next section, but for now, we will break it off here. So that's it for me, thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.